Hi, this video is to show how to get from an STL file that's been generated in some modeling software into CURA for Lulzbot slicing software. This slicing software produces what's called G-code. It basically takes the three-dimensional model and produces instructions for the printer to tell the printer exactly how to produce that model, because as you'll see, there are quite a few options. So for starters, I want to show how to both get from a model in SketchUp. This is a catapult bracket in the SketchUp app. In this online SketchUp app, I would simply export this file as an STL. You notice the little helper text says download model as STL file for 3D printing. So that's what that looks like in SketchUp, download STL, and you'll be able to find the STL model in your downloads. From Tinkercad, which is the piece I'm going to look at in a little more detail, the process is to export. You see the export button, and when you push the export button, a couple of things you'll notice here. You can export the entire design, every model in the design, or just what is selected. So in this case, it looks like I may have some things that are ungrouped. Actually, while I have some things that are ungrouped, I'll just point out that this this hole here is designed for the eighth inch steel axle. An eighth of an inch is about 3 millimeters, and I've just found that sizing the hole at 4 millimeters tends to be a good way to make the clearance hole just right and print just right for being the size to have a good clearance hole size for that eighth inch axle. So I'm going to group these objects. I would definitely want to do that before exporting. So then I would export everything in the design, which is just that one object, and click Export as STL. Now I'm not going to click this because I already have. Over here in CURA, I'm going to click Open File, and I should be able to find that throwing arm reinforcement from a few days back, and it comes into CURA. You'll notice you see this slicing. Now it's ready to save because it's done slicing. So that's how we get an STL file into CURA. In a future video, we'll show some of the different manipulations that you can do to get this ready for printing, and also what some of these colors mean, etc.